So I've made a bunch of videos showing you how to install new and old drives, how to install Windows on them, or how to create them as secondary drives. But one thing I haven't shown you is how to create partitions and how to reclaim unused space. So real quick before I start, what's a partition? Well, a partition is an entire drive, or maybe you feel like a 500 gig might be too much for Windows. You want to partition this out to a C drive, a D drive, an E drive, an F drive. You want it to be multiple drives. You can do that, and I'll show you how to do that here. And we're going to have to dive a little bit deeper for unallocated, and I'll show you that right now. So for unallocated, we can right click on the start button, go to disk management, and here we can see all the drives we have on our computer. First off, this is our C drive. This is where we have Windows installed and where everything is going to download to, of course, unless we change that. And you're all going to have that C drive. Then coming over here, we'll find the D drive. Now you'll notice that this and this match, this and this match, and this match. That's because this drive right here was our Western Digital Blue drive. We cloned this drive onto our 1 terabyte Kingston Fury Renegade drive. Now, because this was a 500 gig onto a 1 terabyte, we have 465 gigs of unallocated space. Unallocated space is space Windows doesn't use, can't really see until you give it a partition. What I was talking about a little bit earlier. So until we give that space a drive letter and a partition, we can't do anything with that. Let me show you real quick how to do that. Now, there are ways to do that from within Windows, from within here, disk management, but rather than show you through here, I'm gonna show you through a program because the program can do so many things that might take a little bit longer to show you. So we'll go into whatever browser, we'll go to partitionwizard.com, we'll go to home, then partition wizard free, scroll down a little tiny bit and download now. Once that's done downloading, it's a tiny download, we'll double click to open it and we'll install it real quick. Under the better choice, make sure you select free edition, continue installing free edition, next, uncheck these if you're not going to use them, and we'll just leave mini tool partition wizard free, next all the way through, yes, and we'll launch it. Let me close this window. All right, so this is mini tool partition wizard free. It's free for now, but that could change at any moment, just realize this. I'm going to have links to everything down in the description below. All right, so here we can see the same thing we saw in disk management, but laid out a little bit nicer. First off, disk 2 is our Kingston M.2 Renegade Fury drive. So we can see our C drive here, and then we can see the unallocated 465 gigs. And this drive is our Western Digital Blue drive. When you click here, disk 1 or disk 2, you're choosing the entire drive. As I mentioned before, these are partitions within that drive, okay? So right now we're focused on the unallocated partition. So I'm gonna show you first the way I like to do it. Rather than splitting up the drive into multiple drive letters, we can right click on the CNTFS and I choose extend. From here, I can claim that 465.8, here it shows 75, it rounds it up, of unallocated space. I can either take up the entire drive by choosing the full drive here, sliding it all the way to the right, or I can slide it right over here. I'm gonna leave it right in the center for now. I'm gonna click okay, and then I'm going to click apply. And yes, it does this thing really quick. So now we'll see 719 gigs. Instead of 465 gigs. So if we go into File Explorer, this PC, we can see the same here. It's using up more of that disk. Now, what about the rest? Well, I could have just slid it all the way to the right so that we have one drive, or I can right click on the unallocated here, go to create this time, and I can choose, this is the C drive's extra space. And I'll leave it as E or F or G, whatever you have your next drive. Again, I can select the partition here by sliding it, or I can leave it at full, click OK, click Apply, yes here, and then come back into File Explorer. And now we have C, D, which is the Western Digital 500 gig. Now the C drive, we just created that, but maybe you want all of that to go back over here. So what you want to do before you do that, just come in here, make sure there's nothing here. You don't want to lose any files. And if it's empty, just come back into Mini Tool Partition Wizard, click on the E drive or the drive you want to delete, choose delete. Now you see it's unallocated again. So we'll right click on that C drive again, extend. Now we have that same prompt we have before. Slide it all the way to the right. Remember, 719.3. So click OK. Apply. Yes. And now we have 930.7 gigs. We'll refresh here. There we go. 930 gigs. And now we're using that Kingston drive in its entirety, like we wanted to. But now we still have that D drive. The Western Digital 500 gig blue drive is an exact clone, just smaller. Let's go ahead and reclaim that space. Coming out of here, now we'll select that drive, selecting here GPT disk one. Disk one is that Western Digital. I'm just going over this again so to make sure you don't delete the wrong drive. Okay, so the Western Digital is that 500 gig we want to clear. We'll right click on that, delete all partitions, individual drives. On that one drive is a partition. Delete the partition. Yes. Now we have an entire 465.8 gigs of unallocated space. We can right click on that. We can do create. Now we have a D drive. So I want to name this WD 500 gig blue drive. Now I know what it is without having to look for it. I want to leave it as the D drive, or maybe I'll pop it over as the J drive. I think I is better. Click OK. We'll click apply. Apply is great because in case you made a mistake here, you have a second chance. Click apply. Your third chance right over here. Yes. Then okay. So now we'll go into File Explorer. Then we'll see here the iDrive, like we selected, is the WD 500 gig drive. Awesome. We just reclaimed our old drive and now we have 500 gigs of space we can use for anything. Maybe I want 250 gigs for music and another 250 gigs for games. Maybe I don't play that many games. Let's do that real quick. So we'll close out of here. We'll right click on this WD 500 gig blue drive and we'll click move and resize. And now I'm gonna slide this all the way to 250 gigs, give or take a few megs, and click okay here. And now I'm gonna rename this one to, by clicking label, to music. And let's go ahead, create a partition on this unallocated drive space. And I'm gonna name this one games, and I'll make that one my D drive because it's more important. Okay, and now these are the two changes that are going to happen now once we click apply. And yes, now we'll come under File Explorer. Now we have our D drive, which is games, and our music drive, which is I. So I hope I helped you out with this in this video. I showed you how to install a secondary drive, how to create the partitions, how to extend partitions, how to break up partitions, showed you everything with partitions, and then how to reclaim drive space on an older drive or maybe your previous Windows drive. That way you have a complete drive and don't need to go and buy another drive if you already have a drive. Now, in the description below, I have every single thing in this machine in case you want to check it out, as well as links to all the software I used in this video. For all the hardware, I do have Amazon affiliated links, so if you want to check them out, you can click on them and go to Amazon. If you buy anything, I do get a very small percentage of that purchase, and it does go to help the channel, and it helps me out a ton as well. This is Iggy with ThisBytesForYou out. See you guys.